वेलकम चिल्ड्रन, साय राम, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल एट योर होम्स. सो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे इज योर एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज क्लास, राइट? एज यू ऑल नो. बट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी, वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू स्टडी एनी चैप्टर. वी आर गोइंग टू डू अ इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग विच यू ऑल लाइक. Yes, today we are going to do map activity or map work. Okay? For that, what are the things you required? You require two maps. You required one physical map of India. This is the physical map of India. Physical map, what is physical map? Which doesn't have any state boundaries. Okay? Physical map is a plain map which only has international boundaries. All right, this is a physical map. So you required one physical map, and second, you required one physical map of the world. Okay, physical map of the world. This is the map. This is the map of the world. So you require two maps. One map from India and other map is the world map, and both the maps are physical map. Okay, pencil, eraser and colors. Colors means wax colors you required. Okay, shall we begin with this? And make sure you are having pencil and notebook with you so that you can write down the question what you are going to do in these maps. All right, so our first question is, draw and color the physiographic division of India in the physical map of India. Write down, draw and color the physiographic division of India in the physical map of India. So what is physiography? Graphic. Physiographic means the physical feature of India. We have to divide India on the basis of its physiographic division. Means we take, in this we take mountains, northern mountains, plains, plateaus, deserts, coastal plains and islands. We have to divide it in this way, physiographic way. Okay, so we have to use physical map of India. In that, we are going to draw the lines with the help of pencil, light pencil, and then we have to do color, and also we have to form a table that showing the coastal plains, mountains, means different colors we are going to use for different divisions. All right? Yes, children, India is divided on six major physiographic division. There are total six major physiographic division of India. First of all, northern mountains, then plains of Ganga, or you can say northern plains. Third, great Indian desert. Fourth, Indian plateaus. Fifth, coastal plains. And sixth, Indian islands. Alright, these six things we are going to draw on physical map of India. Alright, let's start. Yes, children, first of all, we have to draw a table like this on our map. Total there are six physiographic divisions, so we have to make six boxes. Okay? I have made one extra box, but you have to make only six boxes. Draw it. So children, like this we have to make a table and we have to write down all these things. First we will write down northern
mountains. Okay, then we have northern plains, then great Indian desert, then we have Indian plateaus, then coastal plains, and lastly Indian islands. All right, I have already told you that before filling any map, what you have to do, you have to make a table. All right, and these are the six major physiographic divisions of India, means physical features of India. All right, so these spellings are very long, right? So we cannot write each and everything on the map like here. We cannot write it. So what we have to do now, Indian mountains, we have to this box is blank, so we have to give one particular color to Indian mountains. Wherever we show the northern mountains, in the map, we will not write the name northern mountains. What we will do, we will just color that portion with the color same in the box. So the people who is reading your map can easily identify that this color belongs to this. And northern plains, as we have studied in chapter number 2 in map, that plains are always colored with green. Plains are always shown with green color, right? Mountains are always shown with brown color. All right, now here we have in Great Indian Desert. What is the name of Great Indian Desert? Thar Desert. All right, so desert we will make one color. Plateaus are shown with a particular color. Then coastal plains are the area near the sea. This is the coastal plains, so we will give particular color to coastal plains. Then we have Indian islands, the islands of India. These are the islands of India. All right, let's start. See children, I have done the colors. I am showing northern mountains from brown color. I am showing northern plains from green color. Indian desert from mustard color. Indian plateau with yellow color. Coastal plains with pink color. And Indian islands from gray color. So you also have to choose the colors like this, and accordingly we will show the northern mountains from brown color, northern plains from green color, Indian desert from mustard color, then Indian plateau from yellow color, coastal plains from pink color, and Indian islands from gray color. Now children, with the help of pencil, we are going to draw light lines from this to divide the portions. We will start from this point. All right, we will draw a very light line like this. We have to cover the Uttarakhand. Then this is, you know, this is the international boundary. This is Nepal. So touching this line, then this. So that means this area we will do from which color? These are the northern mountains. So we use brown color for this. All right, now we have northern plains. This portion from, this is the curve, and from here, all right, we will draw a rough line. Till here. okay? This is plain area, northern plains. All right? Here also. Okay? Two things are clear, northern mountains, northern plains. Now we have Great Indian Desert, that is Thar Desert. Thar Desert is in which state? This is in Rajasthan. So Rajasthan is here. So this is Gujarat, right? From this point, draw till here. This is Thar Desert. This is Thar Desert. All right. 1, 2, 3. 3 we have done. Now we will start doing the colors in it. Okay. See, I have done the brown color in northern mountains. It is written northern mountains, so I have done brown color in the area which we have drawn. All right. Now it's turn for northern plains. So we have to use green color for this. Which color we have to use? We have to use green color for it. Let's see. So children, this area belongs to northern plains and we have done with green color because in the table we have shown that green color is for northern plains. All right, now we will do the Great Indian Desert. And where we have drawn this? Here. Done? Good. Now the remaining. First we will draw the coastal plains. Coastal plains are the area which is near the sea. All right. So it starts from here. This area is the area of coastal plains. All right, till here. So this is Indian, or you can say coastal plains. And you know that these are two ghats also, eastern ghats and western ghats, right? This you have studied in your previous class. Now we have to do which color in the coastal plains? We have to do pink color in this. All right. And we have to do Indian islands. These are Indian islands, right? Now for coastal plains we have to use pink color. Okay, now do it. So children, we have done pink color, that means we have shown the coastal plains. All right, now we are going to show the Indian islands from gray color. This here is no space, but still these are Indian islands. Now what is left? Indian plateaus. Now the area left, this portion, this is Indian plateau. Okay, and which color we have to do in plateaus? Yellow color.
So children, with this we have finished our map. All right. Your map should also look like this. See, the map from the atlas, Physiographic Division of India. Like this we have done. Right? And now we are going to label our map. This is Northern Mountains. Write down. Northern Mountains. This is Northern Plains. Okay, this is Coastal Plains. Okay, and this yellow color, Indian Plateaus. Okay, which is left? This. Great Indian Desert. Like this, we have to do our map work. We have to label it also. Label it means write down the names. We have draw the table also showing the colors and the name. Alright. I hope this first question is clear and you all will do the map in this way only. Alright. Now children, question number 2. And question number 2 is for world map. Alright. Physical map of world. So what is the question? Write and color the continents of the world. Right. And color the continents of the world in the physical map of the world. You know about the continents? Let's take. There are how many continents? There are total 7 continents. There are total 7 continents in the world. And which is the largest continent? Asia. Asia is the largest continent. And in which continent India belongs? India belongs to the largest continent, that is Asia. And what is the smallest? Which is the smallest continent? Australia. Australia is the smallest continent. All right. So the largest continent in the world, Asia. Second, Africa. Third, North America. Fourth, South America. Fifth, Antarctica. Sixth, Europe. And seventh, the smallest one is Australia. Now we are going to fill this in our world map. Alright, what we have to fill? The 7 continents of the world. See children, in this we have to write down the names of 7 continents, right? So we don't have to draw a table in this. We just write down the names. Alright, where is the largest continent, where is Africa, North America, South America, like this. We only have to write down the names where these places are. Okay. 7 continents, we will start from the largest continent, which is Asia. Alright. So, this is India. We are going to write Asia here. Asia, the largest continent in the world. Alright. Then we have Africa. What do we have? Africa.
okay? Then here, North America. North North America. All right. Now we will write South America. Okay. Now Europe here. This is Asia. Above Africa, we have Europe. Okay. Now the smallest island continent, Australia. Done. How many continents? The largest continent is Asia, then Africa, then North America, South America, Europe and Australia. Alright, let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One is left. Which island is left? Antarctica. So, where is Antarctica? Antarctica is here. Alright, so we will write down its name here. Antarctica. Now we will count once again. First one is Asia, then Africa, then North America, then South America, then Europe, Antarctica and Australia. All right, the largest continent in the world is Asia. The smallest continent in the world is Australia. All right, we have done with this. Now in this same map only, we have to do the next question. In this map only, we have to do our next question. That is question number 3. In question number 3, what we have to do? We have to write the oceans of the world in the physical map of India, world. In the physical map of the world. So this is the physical map of the world. And we have done the continents also here. So we will use this map only for filling the oceans of the world. Alright. Have you written the question? Now, the following are the oceans of the world. The following are the oceans of the world. First is Pacific Ocean. Second is Atlantic Ocean. Third is Indian Ocean. Fourth is Arctic Ocean. Fifth is Southern Ocean. Alright, how many oceans are there in the world? There are 5 oceans in the world. First is Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean and Southern Ocean. Now we are going to fill this. Yes, children. We know Indian Ocean. We all know where is Indian Ocean. Where it is? It is here, this area. All right, we know this thing. We will first write this. We will write full name. Indian Ocean. Okay. Now we have next Pacific Ocean. First is Pacific Ocean. So Pacific Ocean, the area of Pacific Ocean is this. And the area of Pacific Ocean is this. Why is it so? Why the Pacific Ocean comes on both the sides? Because the shape of the earth is spherical, right? And when we fold the map, it will come on both the side. Not on both the side exactly. When we fold the map, it comes on one side only. But if in exam it will come to write down the Pacific Ocean, so you will write here or you will write here, both are correct. Or you can write on both the place, that is also correct. Alright, so we will write Pacific Ocean. And here also. The thing is clear. Okay, now next is Atlantic. This is North America, this is Africa. Between the portion is Atlantic Ocean. What it is? The Atlantic Ocean. So we will write it here. Okay, between America and Africa, Atlantic Ocean. Okay, now three oceans we have filled. We have left with two, Arctic Ocean and Southern Ocean. Where is Arctic Ocean? This portion is Arctic Ocean. If you are using eraser on maps, rub it very softly. Written? Arctic Ocean. Now what is left? Southern Ocean. The name itself is saying its position. Southern means where it is. It is in the bottom. This. Okay, we will write here. Like this, we have to write. First of all, Pacific Ocean on both the side. Then Atlantic Ocean between America and Africa, Europe. Okay, this place. Or if you write it here, it is also correct. Alright, Atlantic Ocean. Then we have Indian Ocean. Then we have Arctic Ocean above in the North Pole. Then we have Southern Ocean in the South Pole. Alright. Let's quickly recap the seven continents. The largest continent in the world is Asia. Then we have second largest, Africa. Then we have North America. Then we have South America. Then we have Antarctica. Then Europe. And then the smallest continent is Australia.
Children, after completing the map, you have to paste these maps in your notebook. Okay? After completing this map, and you have to complete this map with very beautiful handwriting, and you have to do colors very neatly. All right? These three questions you have to do, but you have to purchase only two maps. One is physical map of India and another is physical map of the world. Question number 2 and question number 3 we are going to do in one single map. Okay? Sairam.